Hey geeks, if you're as excited as I am about Netflix's upcoming live-action series Avatar, The Last Airbender, then you're in for a treat. Make sure to stick until the end of this video because today we're diving deep into everything we know about this much-anticipated adaptation. So grab your boomerang, practice your bending, and let's get into it. Before we jump into the new series, let's take a quick trip down memory lane. Avatar, The Last Airbender, originally aired as an animated series from 2005 to 2008. It quickly captured hearts with its rich storytelling, vibrant world, and endearing characters. The story revolves around Aang, the last airbender and the Avatar who's tasked with bringing balance to a world torn apart by the Fire Nation. Joining him on this epic journey are Katara, a waterbender, and Sokka, her non-bender brother. It's a tale of adventure, friendship, and the struggle between good and evil. And fast forward to now, and Netflix is bringing this beloved universe back, but this time with a live-action twist. The announcement alone sent waves of excitement and a bit of apprehension through the Avatar fanbase. Why apprehension, you ask? Well, let's not forget the 2010 live-action film adaptation by M. Night Shyamalan, which let's just say didn't quite hit the mark. But here's why I think Netflix's version could be different. For starters, it's helmed by Albert Kim, who's not just a fan of the original series, but also deeply understands the cultural and narrative significance of Avatar. Kim's vision is to bring a more mature, serialized storytelling approach while staying true to the spirit of the original series. And with the advancements in VFX technology, we're expecting some mind-blowing bending action. Now, onto the cast. A crucial aspect of any adaptation. Gordon Cormier steps into Aang's shoes, while Kaiowen Teo and Ian Ousley bring Katara and Sokka to life. Dallas Liu plays Prince Zuko. Paul Sun-Hyung Lee is Uncle Iroh, and Daniel Day-Kim steps in as Fire Lord Ozai. The casting has been praised for its faithfulness to the characters' ethnic backgrounds, an important step in representation and staying true to the series' roots. Netflix has been teasing us with sneak peeks and stills, but the first trailer dropped during Netflix's Geeked Week, and it was epic. We got glimpses of the characters in action, a look at the world, and, of course, bending. The trailer hints at a more cinematic and visceral portrayal of bending, something Kim emphasized as a key element in this adaptation. As for what to expect, Albert Kim has expressed his dedication to expanding the emotional arcs and storylines beyond what the half-hour animated format allowed. This means we might see deeper explorations of themes like war, identity, and bats. However, with high expectations come concerns. Can this adaptation live up to the original's legacy? Will it manage to capture the essence of Avatar? Or will it fall into the trap of being just another live-action remake? The Avatar community is buzzing with theories, expectations, and, understandably, some skepticism. It's a community that holds this universe close to its heart, so the pressure is definitely on for Netflix to deliver. But from what we've seen and heard so far, there's a lot of reasons to be hopeful. The Last Airbender has the potential to be a groundbreaking series that not only redefines live-action adaptations, but also introduces this incredible universe to a new generation. As we count down to its release on February 22, 2024, let's keep our fingers crossed that this adaptation captures the magic of the world we fell in love with. And that's a wrap on today's deep dive into Netflix's Avatar: The Last Airbender. What are your thoughts? Excited, nervous, a bit of both? Drop your comments below and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more content like this. Until next time, stay awesome.